Hello, thank you so much for clicking my video. And in today's video, I have 6 wigs in the same style but different colors, and they're brought to you by Hair So Flash Shop. I'll be sure to leave a link below to this wig and also their direct store. The brand of the wig that I have today is Sensational. This one, they're Cloud9 Swiss Lace Wigs. The style that I have is Leticia in the colors 2, Flamboyage Mocha, Flamboyage Auburn, Flamboyage Chocolate, Flamboyage Sand, and Flamboyage Blonde. This is what the inside of the color 2 looks like. They pretty much all come the same. You get a 13x6 parting space in the front. You get 2 combs in the front, not too far from the temple. Another comb in a nape area with adjustable straps. The cap material is a stretch fit breathable material. And that is a lot of parting space, so you could part the hair right, middle, or left. And the lace is coming off gray on my skin. I'm going to try my best to tint it to my shade. The hairline on the color 2 comes pre-plucked, and it also comes with baby hairs. I already went ahead and parted this wig to the right side. I would like to do a right side part with this style. Off camera, I went ahead and plucked the hairline a little bit more, but towards the sides, I plucked it just a little too much, so you could kind of see the tracks and the hairline, but I'm still gonna try my best to make it work. Sorry about that. So I would like to have the parting space and the hairline a little bit more flatter and a little bit more sleek. So I'm gonna go in with my Andes hot comb, and the temperature that I have it on is number 5, and I'm just pressing out the hairline and the parting space. This is what the color 2 looks like after I'm all done. This is what the Flamboyage Mocha color looked like, and for this style I did a middle part. What the Flamboyage Auburn color looked like straight out of the box, and for this style I did the half up half down style with a little 2 pieces in the front. This one is Flamboyage Chocolate, and I went ahead and did another half up half down style. Is the Flamboyage Sand color, and me and this one had a little fight. I didn't get a picture of the end results. And this is the Flamboyage Blonde color. I didn't get the end results on this one either.
Hey guys, I hope you are doing well. So I can't believe I'm finally doing this wig. I had this wig since it first came out in so many colors, but I was just so nervous to try her because I'm just like, whoa, this is a lot of hair for the summertime. So I feel like now that it's fall, it's time to bring her out. And the first color up that I'm gonna show you guys is the color number 2. Still got the curls in, looking really nice. You guys know I did a right side part for this color. And in the back right here is where I hook my adjustable straps. I like to hook them as close as possible so I can get a really snug fit. And the cap that I'm going in with underneath today is a brown nude stocking cap. So let's do this install, you guys. So I feel like the lace is blending really nicely with my skin with only just powder. So I'm really excited because sometimes I'll have to go in with foundation also to get the lace to blend, to get out that little ashy tone. So now, if you want, when you install this wig, you can like spray down the whole hairline with like hard hold spray. You can use any hard hold spray you want. You can use the olive oil. There's other hard hold sprays out there. You can use glue, you can use gel, whatever you prefer. But because the lace is laying really flat on my skin, I'm just gonna install the parts that's lifting up. So right now I'm just gonna install the ear tab. But I'm going to leave this ear tab alone because it's being covered and I have other colors to do. So I don't want to make my hairline too tacky. And just going to go in and do it now.
For show and tell purpose, I'm just going in and spraying one layer so I could get it down. And if you like to install this wig, I recommend like 2 to 3 layers so you could have a good proper hold throughout the day.
To style my baby hairs, I'm going to go in with the yellow Got to Be Gujo.
Right here is my almost end results on the color number 2. The length of this wig on me, I would say, is about 22 inches. My height is 5'6". As for the density, it is a very full. If you have a big head, you are in for the clear. This wig is definitely big head friendly.
So this is how it looks long. To be honest, I think I'm going to go in and cut it. Maybe. Hold on. Yeah, I think I'm going to cut it like just a little bit. This is what it looks like long. Keep it long if you want. I like it better cut. Ew. Okay.
Wow, what a difference a cut make. I love this wig way more with the cut. Let me know what you think. So I'm not sure about tangling because I didn't run my fingers through it. I don't want to run my fingers through too much and lose the curls and also make the hair poofy. As for shedding, I'm not sure about shedding either. But like I said, its density is very thick. I like how the lace is blending in with my skin. I'm glad I only got to use powder to blend the lace because sometimes I need to use powder and foundation. But in this case, it's just powder. I also feel like I could have did a little better on the baby hairs. It's not my best, but it's still not bad. Let me know your thoughts. This is the color number 2. And I'm warning you guys now with the rest of these wigs, they're not my best slay. I just mostly wanted to show and tell the colors to you guys so you guys could see the other color options. This was a lot of hair to handle, so go ahead and dislike the video if you want because it's not my best. So like I said before, I warned you guys. I feel like the best job I did was on the color number 2. So let me just get the next color for you guys. Ooh-wee. Y'all probably like, girl, what happened? I was trying to make it work. That's what happened. But it's like as soon as you play with the curls, it's like you lose them and the hair gets really puffy. But it also said this wig is curling iron safe. So I did try to go in and curling iron the hair on 316 degrees. And it holds a curl, but it's still just, it just wasn't working for me with that style. So I was like, let me just try a little pin back style for the poofy parts that's sticking up in the front. A lot of you guys are probably like, Kara, no. But I still want to show and tell you guys the color because Flamboyage Mocha is definitely a hit color. It's really pretty. I love the chocolate color with the blonde tones in it. This is just the best I could do. At least my parting space looks nice. I feel like I got some avatar thing going on right now. Like I'm on my airbender type stuff. I don't know. I tried. But like I said, the color is really pretty. And with this, I'm still not sure about tangling or shedding. But the density is very full, I could tell you that. Next color is Flamboyage Auburn, and this was the half up half down style I was showing you guys earlier. And I just want to spray down the ear tabs so I could keep it down for the show and tell. So again, I'm just spraying the ear tabs of one layer, then blow drying it until it's completely dry. So I like the style that I was going for with this wig, but I just feel like this wig is so full for my little petite self. Like, it's just a lot of hair, but I tried to make it work. I added a few baby hairs in the front, a little swoopty swoops. I could have did better with the baby hairs also, but I was just trying a ting, you know? I also wish there was a little bit more lace on the side, so it would have been easier for when I swooped the baby hairs to get it to look a little bit more natural. But I love how the curls look in the back. It's super cute, giving me pageant vibes. I love the color so much, especially for fall. But like I said, I just feel the density is just so much of me, but it's still a cute wig. I was actually really scared of Leticia, and this was the reason why, because of the density. But hey, I'm just showing to tell you guys the color and just showcasing a few styles. I'm trying to make it work, and I'm just helping somebody else make it work if they got the wig also and they don't know what to do with it. Right here is the Flamboyage chocolate color, and I really wanted this style to work, but the ponytail part is a little loose on my head because it took the shape of the blockhead instead of my head. So it's just really a lot of space at the top, making my hair look big. My head look big. I didn't spray anything on the lace. I don't know why I sucked at the baby hairs today, you guys. I really tried my best. It's just not working. My head looked big. But I like the color. The brown is really calm, not too bright, not too dark. I like the peekaboo highlights that they got going on. And it's just something about the half up, half down style with this wig. And the curls in the back just look so pretty, you know? You know? You feel me? I tried. Don't laugh at me. Here is the Flamboyage sand color, and I lost control, y'all. I lost control. After I did that right side part, I don't know what happened in the front. It just got poofy. The curls never wanted to come back. I was like, no. So I'm just going to try a little low ponytail. I was trying to get it really tight, but it kept slipping back. And I know in order for it to not slip back, I would need to use the combs. But I didn't want it pulling on my edges and then ripping up my hair. So there's just another cute style that you could do just in case you have this wig and you don't know what to do with it. The curls could use a little touching up in the top part of the ponytail, but you guys see the style that I'm going for, right? Right? You feel me? You feel something? No? Okay, my bad. I was just trying to help. Damn, these wigs are working me out. The last color is a Flamboyage Blonde. I was like, let me try something simple and do another right side part. So I just sprayed down the ear tab to help keep it down for the show and tell. Then I go in and style the baby hairs, and this is what it looked like in the end. And it looks really okay. I was hoping it looked more like the color number 2. But I feel like I'm kind of losing the curls in the front and the top part. I tried, y'all. So these wigs definitely do have potential, but that color number 2, I don't care what nobody say, it was a hit. With this one, I'm gonna go in and cut it down because I feel like I lost the curls at the top, and it looks just a little better. It kind of reminds me of Outre Nisha a little bit. Like I said before, these wigs definitely do have potential, but if you do get it or if you do have it, I do feel like you need heat when you part the hair to get like the parting down, because it's going to be a little poofy and humpy at the top. I do like the natural coarse yaki texture that they used on it, but it really doesn't hold that curl once you run your fingers through it. So if you do decide to detangle the curls or loosen up the curls, just be careful how much combing you do with it. So if you have any questions, feel free to comment below and I'll get back to them as soon as possible. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Later, you guys.